National Social Security Fund.
During the second reading, the House Committee considered clause by clause of the NSSF Amendment Bill. A lot of interest was put on clause 10 of the bill that sought to amend section 24 of the NSSF Act to allow 20% mid-term access for savers aged 45 and have been saving consistently for 10 years. The House Committee concurred with recommendations of the Joint Parliamentary Committee of Finance and Gender and Labour that mid-term access was timely, especially at a time when majority of the workers are suffering the diverse effects of COVID-19.
So we thought that mid-term access would help an individual in the mid-age to get your 20%, start up maybe a business. By the time you retire, you are ready, you have tested the deep waters.
I am made to understand NSSF has fears that, the fund managers have fears that this will cause a problem to the government. Right, Honourable Speaker, I would like to state here that really the responsibility, the first responsibility of the fund managers is not to government, but it is to the savers.
However, a decision on this amendment was stayed after government insisted that it should be the NSSF board to determine the percentage.
But we allow the board, in consultation with the minister, guided definitely by actuarial science, to determine what benefits to give out at a given time. So whether 20 or 40 would really be denying the input of technical advice, which is the actuarial professionals. I beg to submit.
The House also failed to agree on the ministry responsible for NSSF, with MPs insisting that it should be the Ministry of Gender and Labour, with Ministry of Finance only responsible for investment decisions of the fund.
Do we have a problem with the current arrangement? I think we don't have. Why would you at this point want the fund to be shifted to Ministry of Finance?
If you remove the finance from the welfare of the workers, what else is left? Because the Ministry of Gender is not going to manage human beings. It's going to manage the pension fund.
You cannot say that Honorable Matia Kaseja will call the chairperson of the board in the boardroom and say, lend me 5 trillion. No, it has to be approved by Parliament. So there are already controls and systems in place.
Meanwhile, the House Committee deleted Clause 19 of the bill that proposed 30% income tax on workers' savings at the time of withdrawal on grounds that the savers are already subjected to this tax.
Honourable members, the proposal is to delete the phrase which may include lending to the government. Put the question that Clause 12 be amended as proposed. Those in favour say aye, the contrary no.
Clause 12 that sought to give government powers to directly borrow from NSSF was also deleted, with MPs maintaining that the fund can only lend to government through treasury bills and bonds. Parliament will continue processing this bill next week. Herbert Ziwa, NTV at Parliament.